Vin Diesel hopes to start a new franchise with Bloodshot. Bloodshot. That's the definition of my eyeballs whenever I smoke weed.
Let's watch this.
We are leading the way to the greatest human advancement of all time.
Wow. It's pretty cool.
It's entirely in our control. And initiate sequence. What happened? You got yourself killed.
You got yourself killed.
I've developed an army of soldiers like yourself. Improved, enhanced.
Welcome to the circus.
The technology.
Isaac Gonzalez.
Will make you faster, stronger.
Harder.
And heal you instantly.
Ooh.
Something about the door. Life in the middle, set the next target for elimination. You are my weapon.
You hate me. But you can't control me forever.
Superhero just got an upgrade.
I'm looking forward to it.
You can't get in, Kenny. No chance. What, man? You shit.
Aldrich Killian's at it again.
I'm well aware this isn't part of Sony's, like, Marvel-adjacent universe they have for me. It's starting to feel like Sony has its own type of look for its comic book adaptations now.
Yeah.
These, like, gritty anti-hero, dark, grimy, sleek.
Yeah.
Very, like, self-serious and very cheesy at the same time, you know? Yeah. And this also simultaneously feels like the culmination of a crap ton of Vin Diesel movies.
Well, you know, Vin Diesel always brings his own Vin Diesel-ness, so I feel like you could interchange Riddick and Bloodshot and a whole bunch of his characters.
A man apart. This trailer had this weird mix of, those are some really cool visuals, to, those are some really bad CGI moments. Like, it's this weird mix of both, because there are some moments that really looked awesome, and then there are other moments that didn't, like, whatever that skyscraper falling sequence
that was, looked very CGI.
That looked like a PS2 video game. But then there are other moments that just look absolutely great. Everything about this feels very cliche. A whole bunch of action movie cliches combined into one. A whole bunch of Vin Diesel movies combined into one.
And a whole bunch of other sci-fi movies, too, because there was stuff that was reminding me of, like, Elysium. There was stuff that was reminding me of Hardcore Henry and Upgrade and things like that.
I like that tagline, superheroes just got an upgrade. Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
It's cool.
And the look of the nanotech is the most interesting visual element they have going on.
And I am a sucker for those things of when they have, like, upgraded AI things that they install into their body. Mm-hmm. You know, like, that's one thing I really loved in, like, Alita. You get a lot of that here with Enhancer Soldiers. There's also some, like, 90s action movie vibes here. I got a lot of, like, Universal Soldier vibes, you know?
Yeah.
Right now, I just can't tell what makes this unique. I have a very strong impression that I'm just gonna have so much fun when I watch this.
Mm-hmm.
And this really looks like the Guy Pearce performance of Guy Pearce is getting his paycheck, because Guy Pearce has never gotten what he's properly due.
No.
Such an, like, broke out onto the scene with LA Confidential and then had, like, a really acclaimed performance with Memento. And there's been some other things he's done recently.
Lockdown. Christmas Carol.
Christmas Carol,
he's good in.
But then he does, like, these performances which just look very cliche. Isaac Gonzalez, I'm hoping, is more than
just hottie girl who shows up for one scene to be authoritative but not kicking ass.
Because she's great in From Dusk Till Dawn. That was the first thing I saw her in, and I thought she was wonderful in that show. I mean, she's, like, very sexy in that show, because she's taking over the Salma Hayek character.
But she's also formidable.
Yeah,
and I mean,
she's got a lot of emotional moments, but it seems like every movie she gets, she's
the
hot.
Same kind of role, yeah.
Do you think her and Vin Diesel had to have a talk about her being in Hobbs and Shaw?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They probably had
betrayed
to.
Betrayed the family. Oh, God. I was never in the family.
Never in the family to begin with.
That's like 5 minutes in that movie.
Maybe that was part of the stipulation. She got to be in this movie for 15 minutes just to outdo her time spent with The Rock.
It's Toby Kebbell? Is that who
Toby Kebbell is Axe.
Underrated actor.
Underrated actor.
Actor who does not get talked about enough. And I hope one day he is someone who is actually famous and gets some like real starring roles. Because I saw brief glimpses of him here. And I'm like, he's probably going to be a nothing character.
I don't know. I mean, yeah, he looks different than I expected based on the vague amount of reading I did on his character. He looks, you know, kind of like a more human level, a little bit more on the weak side. But I don't know. Yeah. I mean, he's also supposed to be the villain, I think. So.
Oh, is he? Toby Kebbell?
I think. Axe is a villain here, but who knows? I mean, could be a different iteration of the comic. I know the characters have changed over time.
I feel like this movie is really trying to push the fact that, like, it's based on a comic book. You might not have heard of this comic book, but it's based on a comic book. So watch it, because it's a comic book movie.
It's going to start the VCU, Valiant Cinematic Universe.
I don't think this movie will do well in the States. I think internationally, it'll probably do great. Vin Diesel is a sensation. Like, I didn't realize till recently just how huge of a star Vin Diesel is overseas.
Not here.
I mean, like, he's big here. We all know who Vin Diesel is. The other franchise that he's had that's worked out well for him, XXX, like, that did not do well. And the last one, didn't Return of Xander Cage, didn't do well in the States. But it killed overseas.
Oh,
and that's just Vin Diesel for you. And I feel like Bloodshot will probably do, this movie will probably do great overseas as well.
I can see that.
I'd honestly be very surprised if this did well in the States. I think I'm going to get exactly what I expect from this. And I feel like I'll probably be okay with it.
Yeah, like a kind of schlocky, pulpy, violent, fun comic book movie that isn't overly inventive in terms of its story or its characters.
I mean, there seem to be some moments that were a little self-aware in its humor, which didn't really vibe well with me with the cinematography, like when it's all red and then he does the smiley face. Like, that's seems a little out of place, but
it's cheeky.
Sure, why not? I think Vin Diesel constantly tries to bring more gravitas to things that don't warrant it.
Yeah, he wants to be given his Oscar-worthy performances in these, like, schlocky action.
That's the thing about Vin Diesel, is he's actually a great actor. Even in Fate of the Furious, where I thought the drama in there did not quite work for me, but Vin Diesel's really delivered. Yeah, he really delivered.
He's really committed.
And he's done other movies that are not these like hyper action filled films where he is a wonderful actor. And I think that's why he's always trying to bring that. But with the way the movies are captured and tonally and stylistically,
this isn't
great. But I could be wrong. I mean, I'd be very surprised if I'm wrong. It's just the two trailers back to back just seem to represent dark aesthetic, hyper cheese, very violent, probably some really cool action though.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. In a nutshell. In a nano nutshell. Yeah.
There's nothing in these trailers that have made me go, I want to know who Bloodshot is. That's the main missing ingredient.
Yeah.
For a movie called Bloodshot, it seems to be primarily selling you on action and style, but and the fact that Vin Diesel's starring in it.
Well, yeah, this seems like what makes the character unique is he's Vin Diesel.
You know? But there's nothing here that is really selling me on this new comic book character or even world.
Mm-hmm. It's selling me on the visuals more than anything.
Mm-hmm.
It's selling me on the, I can't wait to see how many times we get body parts blown apart that we'll reconstruct. like, that's about the biggest grabber for me in this trailer, both of these trailers.
I'm sure I'll be fine.
Yeah. I don't know exactly when coming soon is, but as long as it's March as an early year action movie, I think all it has to do is be fun.
It's going to be forgotten about at the Oscars.
Yeah.
Came out too early.
Vin Diesel always getting snubbed. Baby Groot, come on.
I mean, well, that's just our opinion. We gotta be honest. I mean, it's a comic book movie. We love it. It's gonna be great.
It's gonna launch the cinematic universe.
You know what people say? Subscribe, click bells, like buttons. You know the jazz. Just, hey, let's end this with a Patron of the Day shout out to a man named Matt Beer.
Beer shot.
Met Matt Beer a couple times, or one time. Mm-hmm. A few Google Hangouts and stuff.
Yeah.
One time in person, came on the channel.
Came over.
Very generous human being, very nice fella. Always having bloodshot eyes. Mm-hmm. Why? Because he lives up to his last name. Hungover every single day, downing a whole bunch of Smirnoffs constantly. Corona Lights.
It's a problem.
He makes up for the lack of alcohol percentage by quadrupling up on the quantity of intakes of the bottles.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes he'll drop them into his eyes mm-hmm. and absorb them that way, because you got to make the most out of all your different ways of absorbing, you know.
Roto eye drops.
Ooh, those will clear you right up.
And also, looking for a sponsorship